After we implemented in the previous part the fourth menu commands from the HEC-GeoHMS menu bar titled Characteristics, which include the river length, river slope, basin slope, longest flow path, basin centroid elevation, and centroidal longest flow path. And after we have prepared the raster layers to calculate the different parameters, where the method of preparing them will be explained in the videos coming from the category of or within the playlist entitled Calculating Parameters for the HMS Model. In this part, we will continue the project implementation in HEC-GeoHMS within the ArcMap program to prepare the project file that executable in the HEC-HMS program, where we go to the fifth menu of the HEC-GeoHMS menu bar titled Parameters, and in it we click on Select HMS Parameters. Select HMS parameters. In the input subbasin, we choose subbasin 1. In the input river, we choose river 1. In the subbasin loose method, we choose soil moisture account SMA. In the subbasin transform method, we choose SCS. In the subbasin base flow method, we choose recession. And in the river route method, we choose Muskingum Song. Then, OK. Then a message appears indicating that select HMS parameters completed, then close. Then we go to the parameters menu, and in it we click on river auto name. In input river, we choose river 1, then OK. A message appears indicating that the river auto name completed, then closed, where the name of the water course of river appears in the table of river 1 layer. As we see in the name field. Then we go to the parameters menu, and in it we click on basin auto name and input subbasin. We choose subbasin 1, then OK. Then a message appears indicating that the subbasin auto name completed, then close. Where the name of the subbasin for the study area basin appear in the table of subbasin 1 layer, as we see in the name field. Then we go to the parameters menu, and in it we click on a grid cell processing. In the select the grid cell method, we choose SHG. In the select SHG grid cell, we choose 2000. And in the select the projection, we press on change. Then a projected coordinate system. UTM, WGS 1984, Northern Hemisphere. Then we choose WGS 1984 UTM Zone 38N. Then OK. Then OK. A window titled Grid Cell Processing appears, in which we specify the option as we see, then OK. Then OK. Then the program starts making the grid for the study area basin, as we see. Finally, a message appears indicating that grid cell processing successfully completed, then OK.